Jonathan Ofai Anso is an Africa analyst and founder of Africa Briefing magazine. He joins us now from London. Good to have you with us. Firstly, we're hearing reports that the Rapid Support Forces have somehow managed to shoot down a MiG fighter jet plane belonging to coup forces. It's just a sign that really this ceasefire hasn't been extended. What will it take to get the two sides to really commit to a longer lasting truce?
Well, what it will take from what is going on now, one cannot say exactly what it will take for a lasting truce to take place, unless, except that the two sides have already agreed in principle to negotiate, send representatives to either Juba in South Sudan or to Jeddah in Saudi Arabia. And the conditions for that talks, one of the conditions is that the ceasefire must be adhered to, and that ceasefire will be monitored by national and international observers. And we talk about international observers. You are talking about maybe troops, like some sort of a peacekeeping troop, troops being put on the ground to ensure that the ceasefire is observed. So until that is agreed, that is put in place, I don't see how, on their own, the two sides will agree to a complete ceasefire. We've seen it. Well, there have been two past ceasefires that have been broken, and the current ceasefire that has been extended until Wednesday, tomorrow, is also being broken. So we need a strong international effort, international mediation, to ensure that the ceasefire, when agreed upon, is adhered to.
Meantime, the situation in Khartoum and elsewhere seems to be deteriorating. We've just been looking at pictures of looting there. We've got hospitals and other medical facilities shut down because of the fighting. Food and water are running out as well. The humanitarian situation really is threatening to become a crisis right now. What can be done to ensure that some sort of a corridor is opened up so that international aid can freely flow in?
I think to open a safe corridor, permanent corridor, we need, again, strong international involvement. And when I say international involvement, I mean troops. I mean, that's the only thing, because these two sides are fighting, okay? And they can't seem to agree, on anything. So we need international efforts to make sure that to carve out, the humanitarian corridors and make sure that those corridors are not encroached upon by either side.
Okay, Jonathan Ofai Anso, we will have to leave it there, but thank you so much for sharing your analysis with us.